scenes more reminiscent of Remembrance Sunday. But it's not war dead who are being remembered here. It's people who lost their lives simply because they went to work. When people close to us go off to work, we expect them to come home safe and well later on, don't we? Unfortunately, there's ample statistical evidence to show that in so many instances, it just doesn't happen. So many workers are injured, or worse, killed, in the course of doing their job. And it's that fact which is being remembered at this rally in the city centre. It's Workers' Memorial Day.
I've only been in the industry the short period, but I know a lot of older lads that I work with, they've all experienced something along the years where people have been hurt and they've known people that have died on sites.
As the Work and Pensions MP James Purnell agrees to consult on officially recognising Workers' Memorial Day, safety campaigner Hild Palmer says the problem is not to be underestimated.
We're not talking about freak accidents. You can't prevent them. There are some of those. But when someone has been killed because they were sent to work up a chimney when everybody knew that was a dangerous thing to do, when they're sent to crush canisters which actually explode like a bomb, when they're sent up on a roof that's going to collapse, or they're asked to lift something that £5 worth of safety equipment would have prevented it falling. Those are the sort of things we're talking about. So I don't think our expectations are too high. I think they're too low.
Meanwhile, campaigners Families Against Corporate Killers insist that current workplace legislation is still not tough enough. Kevin Duffy for Channel M News.